go into debt because we want to be artists. Hey y'all. Hello my dears and welcome to my channel. For those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Lisbeth. I'm a published author here in America. So in this video, I'm going to be teaching you super easy hacks. I'm so serious. Super easy hacks and give you lots of tips on how to put together a strong portfolio so that you have a greater chance of getting into the school of your dreams and hopefully getting yourself some scholarships so you don't have to go into debt because you want to go to art school. We don't want to go down that path, y'all. So, my YouTube babies, I'm going to teach you how I put together my portfolios so that you can get into the school of your dreams. I'm not going to go into too much detail at all about what I feel about art colleges. And that's for another video completely. Disclaimer! Attending art school does not necessarily mean you'll become a better artist, nor does a degree in art guarantee a successful career in art. Art school will simply give you the time, space, and projects you may need to experiment, think outside the box, and hopefully develop your style and skills. However, if you're lazy or afraid to get out of your comfort zone, girl, you'll be wasting your time in art school, so don't do that. Now, without further ado, let's get started. Now, the first thing you want to do before you start putting a portfolio together is find out how many pieces are permitted in your portfolio submission. Now, some schools will ask for 20, some are 25, some are 30, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to pretend that the school we're trying to get into is asking for 25 submissions, okay? So 25 is the number we're working with. Keep that in mind. Now, the next thing you need to do, even if you have to write it down, think of all the art mediums that you are comfortable with and feel that you're really good at. So for this example, I'm going to use myself. I'm going to say markers. I would say oil paint, acrylic paint, and pencil. Let's put color pencil in there. Let's say clay. 25 submissions is what we need, and I have just chosen 5 mediums that I feel I'm pretty strong at. So 25 divided by 5 equals 5, right? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So that means for every medium that I feel I am good at, I can have 5 submissions. Pretty easy, right? But there's more to it than that. We as artists tend to gravitate towards our favorite pieces, and those end up being the ones that make it to our portfolio. But the problem is, sometimes our favorite pieces aren't exactly our strongest pieces. You know what I'm trying to say? Sometimes we favor a piece and it's not even the best example of our work or what we're capable of doing. So really look at your pieces and really try to look at it through the point of view of someone who's trying to examine your art and examine your portfolio. Like, pretend you're somebody from the school that you're trying to get into and try to imagine what they would think while looking at your artwork. Like, if you send them a painting, now, does it showcase your style? Is the brush strokes really nice? Is it clean? Is it put together? Is it detailed? Or, you know, like really look at it and see what the strong points are compared to some of your other examples of your paintings. You know what I mean? And try to pick the strongest examples.
I think I'm kind of good at like 8 different mediums.
That's completely okay. You can have one medium with a little bit more than the others, but you definitely want at least 2 examples. The next thing to keep in mind wholeheartedly, and this, I emphasize this for anybody who only draws realism or anyone who only draws cartoons, anime, and manga, you need to show that you are versatile. I cannot tell you how many times people who review my portfolio for my scholarships were shocked that I also drew anime and manga. Because when they would look at my sculptures and my paintings and my pencil drawings, they were all hyper-realistic because they're so used to students only being able to do one thing. If they do cartoons, their whole portfolio tends to be cartoons. If they do realism or abstract art, it all tends to be just that. You know what I mean? But when you show variety, you show that you are an asset to their school. You show them, I'm not just coming to your school to play games. I'm serious about my art education. And showing versatility will 100% show that. I'm just trying to help you guys, and a lot of people don't like hearing this, but it's the truth. A lot of younger people, they're really in love with drawing cartoons, and I get it. That's my favorite thing to do too. But I also understand the importance and the value behind being able to draw from life. And in terms of getting a scholarship to a school, you need to show that you deserve it more than the other guys. Also, not getting into art school does not necessarily mean you're not a good artist. Look at me, I'm 100% self-taught and taught myself everything I know, so you can do that too. So if art school isn't in your future, me and my channel are always here for you. You got this, boo-boo! Another thing to keep in mind is, you don't want to just have just people or just landscapes. You also want to have at least one or two still lives, like putting together, you know, it's a little basic, but it really does show that you have a wider range. You know what I mean? Putting together some fruit, a wine glass, whatever, fabric over a chair, and just draw that. It really will show your range. And if it's not very good at first, do it again, try it again. You want to show that you can do these things. However, I am not saying throw away your individuality and your personal style. And no shape or form am I saying that. Most of your pieces, I think it's a good idea to show your own personal style and your own personal interests, but do not get caught up in just that. That's why I said I have one or two still lives thrown in there that are really good examples of you drawing still lives and inanimate objects or sceneries, because you need to show that. It's a good idea to show that. It proves, look, yes, I draw cartoons. Yes, I draw, you know, in this particular style that I have developed. But that doesn't mean I'm limited as an artist. Because look at how realistic this tree is. It gives them more respect for you too. Another thing to keep in mind is, if you have a special skill such as silk screening or you dye fabric, it's a really good idea to include that in your portfolio. Some of the things that I included in some of my college portfolios is my editing work. So I actually brought copies of my manga. These are both volume 3 of my series, but one is the copy that you would find in stores, and this one was the limited edition copy that only the first 500 people who ordered actually got. So I showed this to them. They saw the cover. I told them, yes, I edited it myself, and I edited the interior pages. I drew everything by hand. It was all screen print and India ink and quill pens. And they loved the fact that this thing that they were holding in their hands, I made myself from top to bottom, exterior, interior, was all me. Like I said, versatility, you want to show them that you're capable of a lot more than just one thing. I really do believe that everything that you get out of art school is only because you put in the effort. I don't really believe that art schools can really teach you how to be a good artist. Anything you get out of art school is because you put the effort into it. You know what I mean? Art school is really there to give you a place to explore and to try new mediums and hopefully get some guidance from your professors. But in actuality, it's really up to you guys. And if you want to go to art school, you need to be really serious about studying art on your own, about practicing every day. And if you don't know how to do that, please check out my artist life hack videos, which teaches you how to draw everything from hands, feet, bodies, all that good stuff. And I promise you, they will help you so much on your artistic journey, guys. But seriously, if you go to art school, don't waste your time. Work hard, because it costs money. Money to go to art school. I hope that this video was super useful for you guys. Please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and don't forget to subscribe. So until next time, guys, please take care, God bless, and do not be afraid to nerd out. Take care.